This homily I titled it, Everyone is Called, Everyone is Important. Everyone is called, everyone is important. Draw me nearer to thee, Lord.
Because he does not follow us.
We try to stop him because he's not a Catholic. We try to stop him because he's not from St. James. We try to stop him because he no longer goes to church. We try to stop him because he's not from America. We try to stop him because he has no degree. We try to stop him because he doesn't belong to our ministry. Jesus Christ said, no, you had it wrong. Everyone is God. Everyone is important. Don't stop anyone. We are on a common journey. We are on this race together. Everyone is important. Likewise, in the first reading of today, God granted 70 elders with a gift of prophecy. Now, two men, Eldad and Medad, they were not in the gathering. Yet, they received that gift. And suddenly they started prophesying in the tents. And then Joshua came again to Moses and said, this is not right. This is not right. These two men were not with us. Go and stop them from prophesying because they didn't receive that gift. Moses said, no. You had it wrong. Everyone is God. Everyone is important. You can't stop the Holy Spirit from flowing wherever it wills. Moses said, don't be jealous. Don't be angry. How I wish everyone were prophets. How I wish everyone could do what I am doing right now. Don't stop anyone from prophesying. Don't stop anyone from sharing his own gift, her own gift, her own talents, wherever he is. And so, friends, how about we ask ourselves some of these questions? How often do we drive people away from our lives? How often do we drive people away from the circle of our own friends? How often do we make derogatory remarks about other people? And these derogatory remarks make them feel bad. How often do we tend to discourage others from achieving their own goals by telling them you're no good, by telling them you can't make it, by telling them you don't have the skills, you are a failure? How often do we use such derogatory remarks? How often do we drive people away from our own ministries? And probably you have maybe heard this remark, that I've been in charge of this ministry for so many years, for 10 years, for 20 years. Therefore, I have the right to say who joins this ministry and who does not join this ministry. Or maybe because this place is not my friend, then he cannot join this ministry. And the question is, do you know that the blessings that God has given to you is not for you to keep for yourself alone? Those blessings are for you to share with everyone. And so the message of today that Jesus Christ is telling each and every one of us, that we are one, that all of us have been called for reasons, and we are called to utilize our own talents, our own gifts, for the good of everyone. We are reminded that we are on a common journey. We are on a mission. And that mission is to see God face to face. And in order to see God face to face, the gospel says today, if your eyes causes you to sin, pluck it out. What are those things that we can remove in our eyes for us to see God face to face? We can remove in our eyes by biting. We can remove in our eyes anger. We can remove in our eyes hatred. We can remove in our eyes malice. Don't be envious of other people's talents. The gift that God has given to you is not the gift that God has given to you, to me. And that was the reason why Mother Teresa said that there are things you can do and I cannot do them. There are things I can do and you cannot do them. But together, we make great things. It takes a teamwork to make the dream work. No one has ever achieved success alone. We all need each other to succeed in life. We have to work together. We have to take the journey together. We have to run this race together. And we'll be happy at the end of our lives. I would like to end my homily with a quote from Henry Ford. He said, coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success. And so like Jesus Christ and Moses today, let us see the good in each other. Let us not just see the mistakes. Let us stop bullying each other down. Let us uplift the spirit of one another. Let us take this journey together and know that we have been called to love ourselves. Let us walk together. And when we walk together, we will achieve our goal. Let us make this race a common race, a common journey with one spirit. And at the end, we will live with God. At the end, Christ will say, come and be with me, good and faithful servants. For you loved each other when you were in the world. For I was hungry given to eat, I was thirsty given to drink. Naked you clothed me, in prison you visited me. Come and be with me. Let us love one another. Let us walk together. Let us seek for what unites, not what separates. And on the last day, we will be with God in heaven. Lord, my songs every day, Father, draw me nearer.